All right, here we are for round one. We're on the play. This hand's not great, but if it draws an island, it goes off pretty well. I'm actually going to lead with Mutavault because we'll probably business them on turn two. Somehow the stack is there. All right, well, immediately punished for not leaving up mana tithe. Although maybe now we'll get to counter something even better. Could put my Mutavault at risk here. Probably shouldn't. Probably best not to do that. And I think we'll just jam Blade Splicer. Mutavault also works nicely with Blade Splicer, so we have five blockin' toughness if we need it. Or five first striking blocking, I should say. What's all this then? Lucranus. Boy, I wish we had a blue mana to mana war that. That would be pretty sweet. Guess we just pass and then take five when we get crashed. I don't really want to cast Gather. I want to mana tide the next play. I wonder what our opponent could have that would let them not just get their Elvish Mystic eaten with that first attack. Okay, Kadama's Reach, that's fine. Yeah, I really should have played Plains on turn one. We're getting punished pretty badly. Got a mountain and a forest. Lucranus going to attack? Might not realize that Mutavault has first strike. Yeah, I guess he does. Bummer. But he didn't play a land from his hand. That's kind of odd. Alright. Yeah, I don't want to gather the townsfolk when Lucranus can just eat them. Just gives him another good thing to target with it. It is nice to see justice for us playing both of these, just immediately punished. I definitely appreciate that, to some extent. Yeah, we have to force this. I think we ditch Ponder because we're not going to have time to mess around with that. We're going to just have to draw well because we've been mana screwed for a couple turns now. Yeah, we're not going anywhere quick. That's for sure. Sure. Xenagos is in there. Okay. Oh, I could have manatied that. That was silly. I probably should have done that. Yeah, I definitely should have manatied that. That was bad. All right, island. No. All right, we're done here. We can't win this game. Even if we draw an island at this point, we're just too far behind. Okay, so sideboarding. Yeah, I didn't want to change. I don't think we want to change much. I think our plan looks like it's mostly good. I'll just run it back. All right, here we are for game two. We're on the play. This hand, I think, is a keep. We have turn one Ancestral, and then we can preordain into, hopefully, some lands. So we get to basically look at the top four cards of our library to find a land. So we'll get a draw step, then we can look at two with three with preordain. Oh, or we can just find a land right away and play Augur and miss. That's fine, though. Happy to just have a 1-3. I guess we actually already had five spells in our hand, so we were probably pretty likely to miss. Now we'll try and find some lands and fail. Yep. Well, at least we can mana tithe. We've seen three different 4-mana Planeswalkers, so we can mana tithe whichever one gets cast here. We've also seen Pelucrano, so we've just seen a ton of 4-drops. I care the least about Pelucranos, but I think we just have to mana tithe anything that we can. We're so tight on mana at this point. Alright, three lands is actually what I want to see there. Just want to keep making those land drops. And then eventually we can maybe win with, like, secure plus part or something like that. Xenagos, okay. Xenagos is going to add a mana. And do what with that? Nothing. Interesting, just wanted plus one loyalty rather than a 2-2. Oh wow, that was a good draw. Alright, well, we get to Homp Xenagos. That's pretty sweet. It's just perfect. And then we can have Cryptic Command up to eventually set up our big Secure the Waste turn. Like, if we go end of turn Secure for 5, untap, part the Water Veil, smash for a bunch, I think that should work. We're also a decent number of cards into our deck for the purposes of finding opposition, which I assume would also probably just be enough for us to win. Right, like we put three cards on the bottom with Augur, two with Preordain, and then we've drawn an extra three with Ancestral, so we've been through a lot of cards. We put a total of 5 non-opposition cards on the bottom. Witness, Returning Witch, Pelucranos or Xenagos? Xenagos, okay. I'm actually less scared of Xenagos than I am of Pelucranos because we have so many ways to deal with it. Like, Pelucranos could come down and kill a lot of our tokens, which would be annoying. Ooh, a little Jace. I think I'm just going to make a 1-1. And See, we saw Woodfall Primus that could kill one of our Planeswalkers, but that doesn't really matter. Yeah, I'm just going to play Jace, and I think I like bouncing Elvish Mystic. Just keep our opponent off of anything too devastating. Our hand is already pretty good, so we don't really need to brainstorm that badly. We just have to make sure nothing terrible happens to us. And Elspeth gives us the opportunity to just kill Xenagos if we need to. And then next turn we can just cast Part and have two Planeswalkers going. That seems really strong. We play Elvish Mystic, sure. Okay, Xenagos comes back down. We're just gonna kill it, though. Okay, sure. So I guess we have to decide what we're going to do this turn. I guess I like brainstorming to start. We can go brainstorm, kill Xenagos. So that guarantees we'll hit our land drop next turn. Or this... Yeah, I already played a land this turn, yeah. So we'll hit our land drop next turn for sure. I think I like casting Part here then. We'll go plus here, kill Xenagos, and take an extra turn. And this turn, I think we just attack for one with our soldier because I think we're going to make another soldier. And put that Elvish Mystic back in our opponent's hand and leave up Cryptic Command. Sounds good. Oh, there's Opposition and Dictate. That's pretty nice. Maybe I should have brainstormed before I attacked, I guess. So we could play Opposition and Blade Splicer. That sounds actually just better than leaving up Cryptic Command. We'll keep those red sources locked down. Okay, looks like O-Ring is here to take care of Opposition. Do we want to tap Eternal Witness in response? No, I don't think so. Our opponent only has green mana available. Can't really think of much you can do with that. So now we have Dictate available. Make another 1/1. I just want to keep hitting our land drops because we have... Revelation and Secure the Wastes. I guess I'll keep Manowar in our hand. We'll just put back these two. Or maybe not. Actually, maybe I'll put back Revelation because we're not going to cast it this turn anyway. We'll just play that and play the Spirit Keeper. And then attack with everyone. Or not attack. There's no reason to attack. We can just opposition everything. Oh, wait. We don't have opposition in play anymore. Oh my god, I'm so stupid. Well, whatever. I don't think we can realistically lose from here. We have Cryptic and Dictate of Heliod available. 7 mana plays you a Hornet Queen. So, let's see. If we play Dictate, that's 3, 6, 9, 12. Yeah, we have lethal. Okay. So we'll just let Hornet Queen resolve, play Dictate, and then we're going to Cryptic Command to tap his guys. Obviously not attacking last turn was stupid, but it doesn't matter. We are still going to win easily. Crunch. All right. Yeah, I don't really want to change anything. I think our deck is pretty well positioned, or at least as good as it can be. Wouldn't mind extra counter spells, but we don't have any, so there's that. Yeah, let's just run it back. Alright, here we are for game three. We're on the draw. This hand looks excellent to me. We have Manowar into Jace. Jeez, turn one Elvish Mystic every time. I'm going to preordain and try to find us a white source. Bottom those. Alright, there's our white source. That's good. Go ahead and play that so we can hopefully counter whatever 4-drop our opponent has. The deck is long on 4-drops to be sure. Yeah, Pelucranos countered. Fine with just getting a basic plains here because we have plenty of blue sources, so we'll be able to cast Cryptic if we draw it anyway. So I think this turn I'll play the Mishra's Factory and Manowar. Ooh. Is it better to Harbinger? Well, alright, now I'm regretting not finding Hollowed Fountain. Because what I want to do is play Mishra's Factory, and that way we can still threaten Xenagos if Xenagos shows up. But I guess I could play Harbinger and Soldier of the Pantheon. Nah, that's probably better. I'll do that. Yeah, this way we still can threaten to kill Xenagos if our opponent plays one. Eternal Witness back Pelucranos. Okay. So now I think we'll play Jace, probably. Yeah. And just bounce Elvish Mystic, I guess. Actually, we haven't seen any 6-drops yet. And yeah, I think we'll just... We can either brainstorm... Yeah, I think just brainstorming is probably better. All right, well, I don't really want Ancestral Vision, so I'll set it so that I can scry that away. It's not that Ancestral Vision is bad, it's just that we're not going to have a great opportunity to use it. Pelucranos in. Oh. Well, that's not going to work out very well, because Soldier of the Pantheon can block this pretty easily. Could have traded Harbinger for it, but I don't even think we want to do that. Okay, so now we'll scry that away. And then, do we want to brainstorm? If we find Force of Will, it's really, really good. I think I want to bounce Elvish Mystic this turn, unless we find Force of Will. There's Force of Will, nice. So, we can't cast Cryptic this turn, so we'll put back Cryptic in Plains, and then just play Opposition. Now we really don't have that much to fear. So, just pass and tap down Elvish Mystic. I guess it's better to just tap down Mountain. Well, I should just tap down Raging Ravine. Our opponent's probably not going to attack it into Soldier of the Pantheon again. Sure. I wouldn't mind having our own Oracle of Moldiah, which Treachery could set up for us. Oracle Jace is such a strong combo, and we'll get it for two turns. So now that they've tapped out, I'm just going to go ahead and tap down this Eternal Witness. I don't really want to trade Soldier of the Pantheon for it. So this is going to be a pretty powerful turn. We're going to Treachery Oracle. Brainstorm with Jace and put back two lands. And then Time Walk. Smash for four. Play a couple of lands. Play a land and then brainstorm. We're not going to get to play another land this turn, but that's okay. I think we're going to probably play Dictate plus Gather. So I'll put back Seeker and Sphinx's Revelation. Actually, maybe it's better to play Geist. Yeah, we can do that. So we'll play Geist. I think we just pass. I think there's not much upside to attacking here, and we can just tap down a bunch of our opponent's stuff so they don't really get to, they can't really do anything. I don't really care if Jace dies at this point. I think I'd just rather deny our opponent lands. Access to mana. Yeah, that seems reasonable to me, considering that we get to just attack for lethal next turn anyway. Also, Mishra's Factory can theoretically eat Eternal Witness if it attacks. Alright, just passing. So now we'll play Gather. Tap Eternal Witness. Four. Yeah, this is plenty of damage. Alright. Well, that went pretty well despite a rocky start. And yeah, we took some sweet Part the Water Rail turns, and we'll be back for round two.